My name is Pan Derben. I'm a father of three kids, two boys, 13 and 9 years old, and a 4-year-old daughter. I live in Waterloo and works in Waterloo as well. Today, I'm here on behalf of Parents Alliance of Ontario, which has more than 3,000 members, and I strongly support Trustee Watson's motion. I ask you to support it as well for the sake of innocent kids and all Waterloo Region's parents who voted you, dear trustees, to present them on the matters of their children's education. As a parent, I have deep concern about the 2015 sex education curriculum. In general, the Ontario government disrespects the difference of culture, faith, social and family values, pushed the sixth education agenda written under the direction of convinced child pornographer Ben Levin.
Point of order.
Yes.
They're not supposed to be references to personal.
Yes. So could you please not reference any personalities or people specifically?
The new sex education curriculum will plant wrong seeds in wrong season. It promotes sexual pleasure and sexual freedom, confuses children with six different genders and a variety of sexual expressions and orientations. It denies parents and the primary educator and detach sex from love, commitment, responsibility, marriage, faith, moral value, and social value. Young children are groomed toward sexual exploitation and promiscuity, which only result in sexual transmitted infections, HIV and AIDS, pregnancy, cancer, and self-destruction. The STI HIV teaching in the curriculum misleading children that sex is safe as long as they use condoms. This is very misleading. It normalizes high risk of sexual behaviors and equalizes homosexual and heterosexual acts in the young minds. It failed to mention that anal sex greatly increases the risk of HIV infection and people could die of HIV AIDS. What in the curriculum says that one of the best things you can do to prevent HIV is to stop the stigma that is associated with having the infection. This is very misleading. How in the world a school curriculum introduced by the government can be this misleading? The province of New Brunswick has implemented the comprehensive sex education since 2005. The data from New Brunswick shows that STI steadily went up over the years, and the teen pregnancy increased by 40% 5 years after the CSE. While at the same period, Ontario teen pregnancy decreased by 7%. If children in Ontario are outdated in the engaging in sexual activity and thus resulting in less teen pregnancy and STIs, it's not a bad thing at all. We want our kids to be kids. Second, there are the community partner and organization which will engage and mentor young children's sex education inside and outside of the school. Is there any supervision system in checking the contents and age appropriate? Who will there be to guard the safety of our children? Third, there's missing, what's missing from the sixth education curriculum is even more worrisome. Rape, pedophilia, child pornography, and incest are not brought up and warned and as a criminal. The potential threat and harmful effects posed as young children by adult sexual predator or adults that might be interested in obtaining material about their bodies are not mentioned. It forced parents to ask whether this omission is intentional or not, and to what extent this omission was influenced by some people. In overall, with the new curriculum, the moral faith and traditional values have been removed from the classroom and the society. The concern about the Ontario 6th education is no longer simply just why teaching the six-year-old child about their private body parts. It is in a very large scale about the all against the children and family in faith, which has taken hold of the public education system. The classroom has become an arena of conflicts between the traditional value and the new value. It's coming to school as to school of Ontario, just like many places of Canada, which already have. So it is my humble plea to all of you, the school board members and elected trustees, please speak up for your children and use your power to support Trustee Watson's motion to hold information to all parents across Waterloo region so that they can publicly ask questions and answer their concern. Parents are taxpayers and support the public education. They deserve this to openly ask questions. I also appeal you to send a letter to the Ministry of Education to release the consultation report from 4,000 parents conducted in 2014 for this sixth education curriculum. You will be appreciated by thousands and thousands of parents of Ontario and the children of generations to come. Let kids be kids. Thank you very much for your time.